Stop! Not another step or I shoot.
Wait. I have come on behalf of the Marquis de Lafayette.
He's taken an automat for his aide-de-camp. You're no more human than the machines that laid waste to this city.
I was not given the same orders as the others, monsieur.
Just what mission has the Marquis entrusted you with?
I must meet with Abbé Grégoire.
Alas, you've come too late. The abbot has got it into his head to go to the Palais de Justice. He is certain that Monseigneur de Lafar, the Bishop of Nancy, is being held prisoner by the monstrosity that is wreaking havoc on the Ile de la Cité. But how can he possibly hope to free him? The abbot is a holy man. He would lay down his life to right an injustice. But there isn't one among us who stands the slightest chance against that thing. Not the slightest chance.
Le Palais de Justice.
Thank you. You. You were made of neither flesh nor blood. You were an automat like those who committed this massacre.
I have received no such command. I am carrying out a mission on the orders of the Queen. Your friend on Place Saint-Marie informed me of your intentions.
Alas. I was not able to reach the Palais de Justice. I fear that the soul of Monseigneur de la Fare is lost forever.
Was he killed?
What has been done to him is a fate worse than death. Far worse. But I could go no further. There were so many bodies, so many innocents strewn about the square. The air there, there was something sinister about it. I felt it poisoning me, body and soul. As for getting back to the Société, it's hopeless. The streets are teeming with machines, but the machine that is wreaking havoc in the area around the Palais is colossal, much, much larger than yourself. What's more, the soul of His Excellency the Bishop has been imprisoned within this monstrous machine. I'm certain of it. Have you seen the flames coming from the Palais? I don't think any.
I, Henri de la Fare, Bishop of Nancy, ask the Lord to bless this assembly and watch over this meeting of the Estates General. Let us not turn a blind eye to the misfortunes of a populace who is condemned to the most abject poverty, for there is no greater sin than to ignore the suffering of one's brethren. Of the court is an insult to the misery that reigns in our lands. In such dark times, how can one conceive of hiding away to play shepherdess or tinker with clockwork contraptions?
What happened? You stopped moving. I feared you had broken.
I do not know. I only touched this ring.
Monseigneur de la Fare's ring. Artemisson, whoever you are, help him, please.
Lord,
let not that his soul be forever lost. Make haste, I beg of you.
is gone. All that remains is the massacre.
I have seen these machines in action. I know all too well their capabilities. I implore you for Namipa's source! She can then heed my words. Flee!
We must leave this place, Monseigneur. There's no time.
Take this to the clerk's office at the Châtelet.
The Châtelet prison is at the other end of the Pont en Change. This grappling hook will be very useful.
Quickly.
Dieu soit loué. It is such a blessing to see you safe and sound.
This belongs to you.
Bless you, whoever you are. You have our eternal gratitude.
I believe you've met Monsieur Julien Raymond from distant Saint-Domingue. He's one of the most eminent members of our organization.
And you, Mademoiselle? What should we call you?
My name is Aegis.
Ah, yes. The Aegis. The mighty shield and scourge of Zeus.
I wonder. Earlier, by the Pont Neuf, when you touched Monseigneur's ring, can you explain what happened?
The ring called to me. It compelled me to reach out and take it.
Come now.
The moment I touched it, I was transported. Somewhere else. It was the same strange world that you were in, Monseigneur.
Hell, you mean?
Or purgatory.
I saw things there. I saw Monseigneur giving a sermon.
What wickedness is this?
This explains the moment when you froze. And this isn't the only time you've experienced something like this, Lesbar.
That is correct. It also happened with two objects I found in Place Dauphine.
And what happened there?
That is where I found your Bible and your cross, Monseigneur.
How did you know they belonged to me?
They demanded to be returned to you. You did not regain consciousness until I did so.
This is madness.
Let us not be so quick to judge, Monseigneur.
I witnessed the moment when your cross was taken from you. Then I saw you being locked in that box.
Et bien voilà. It is just as I suspected. Here, Aegis, look at this. Over the course of my research, I unearthed this ancient document. I believe I have finally uncovered its meaning. It's a triangle with an identical inscription at each corner. Nemi, memory in ancient Greek. Then, in the center, there is an open eye which symbolizes awakening. Do you understand? The images you saw, Aegis, were Monseigneur de la Fare's own memories. Three echoes of the past tied to personal objects of his. Three Nemi's memories which some dark alchemy had taken from him. Without them, his mind would have remained lost, incomplete. He would never have regained consciousness. But by returning these three objects to him, Aegis, you were able to save his immortal soul.
Tell me, Aegis, when you were at the clerk's office at the Châtelet, did you perhaps see a leather wallet near the abbot's documents?
No, Monseigneur.
Ah, that is unfortunate. Most unfortunate.
Good man. I need a moment alone. I must read. Never mind that.